to my channel. My name is Brittney Bundles, and today is going to be another vlog. I'm really excited that I'm doing more vlogging. That was one of my goals. So thank you for all of those that support me and the vlogs and that like the vlog content. So if you do like the vlog content, I'm really trying to keep that going. Be sure to leave me a comment or give me a thumbs up. That way I know that you're watching it. I know that you enjoy it, and I'll keep trying to bring more vlogs to you. So if you are interested in today's vlog, today I need to go to Walmart. I need to get some more things for, or more items for my 4-inch samples that I'm going to be sending out. I also need to go to the post office, mail out some hair, and not only that, but I also need to get branding items. I have 4 or 5 clients that sent in branding items, and everything arrived on Saturday. Today's Monday. So I'm going to be going there to get the branding items and then emailing everyone back to let them know that I received their branding items. If you are kind of confused as to what I'm talking about, I am referring to my drop shipping service through badchickhair.com, where I offer different tools and services for people that are wanting to start hair businesses or that have hair businesses and are looking at alternative options instead of purchasing directly and, you know, through wholesale or in bulk at this time, or people that are looking at purchasing in bulk. I have wholesale options as well, and people that are also looking at both options. There are people that not only drop ship, but people that also purchase wholesale. So it just depends on what's going to work best for you. And then not only that, I offer consultations where we can go over a different strategic action plan, and you can kind of outline action steps that are going to get you closer to your goal and just different things. So if you have time, make sure you check out my website, which is badchickhair.com. The link is always down below. But that's what I'm going to be doing. I ran out of these bags. These are the bags that I use for my 4-inch weft samples, and I have 2 left, and I have about, I have enough that I need to actually get done. Typically what I tried to do, even back in my salon days, is I would try to get the samples already ready and just like in a bin, so that when someone ordered, I can just go ahead and pull the samples already pre-packaged out of the bin and then go take them to the post office and mail them out. However, I stopped doing that. I just started doing them as I received orders, and I have designated days. So I have certain days where I do my wholesale orders. I have certain days where I do my 4-inch weft samples, because those do take the most time, just because you actually have to get out the bundles and cut, you know, 4 inches, and then put them inside of the bag in a way that's not going to mess up the extensions in any way. And then also I label each of the baggies or each of the extensions, the samples, with a business card, and I write on top of the business card the texture. So if I get some time this week, I'm probably going to go ahead and just work more on getting a lot of samples ready, pre-packaged. That way when I do get sample orders, it just makes the process go more efficiently. I just haven't had the time to do it. Like I said, I used to do it in the salon when we had downtime. But you know, everything, I'm just trying to fit everything in, you know, so I haven't had the time to designate to cutting the samples, but it definitely would make my, job or my day-to-day, task way more efficient. Also, I was going to do my nails. This is the towel that I'm using right now for my nails. But I'm not going to do it today. I also want to, go to the beauty supply store. I need some pins to put in this wig. Now this wig I have worn, but I want to wash it and I want to flat iron it, or maybe even put some curls in it and show how pretty it really is. I mean, like, again, right now it's been worn and this has been sitting here for a while. It even like got tipped over a couple times, so this wig is fail. You're going to be able to see it a lot better once I wash it, but this is after I've worn it a few times. This is the bang wig that I wore. I think I wore it in like 1 video, the bang wig, but besides the video, I was wearing it just like in my normal day life too, just around. So it definitely has gotten oils in it from my natural hair, and like I said, it's been not cared for. I did not put it into like a plastic bag, or I didn't store it correctly. I just kind of set it up here and it has been falling because I don't have any clips. I can't find, not my clips, but the, what is it called? You know what I mean? I can't find any of those tacks. I'm just going to call them tacks right now. I cannot think. I haven't even had coffee this morning, but I can't find any of, you know, what I need to actually keep the wig pinned down to this wig or to this styrofoam head. So I'm going to be working on that too. You'll probably see me like wash the wig and flat iron it. What I'm doing right now is I'm just in the phase of trying different wigs, because I want to bring wigs back to my website, but I don't want to just bring them back. I don't want to bring wigs back that I'm not really, really in love with. Now, I love this wig, but I still want to wear it a little bit more. I want to try some different things with it. I do want to try to dye it. I also want to try and curl it different ways before I just slap it on the website. So I've worn it a few times. Like I said, I do like it. I also want to take the density out of these bangs. Like, these bangs are nice, but they're just too thick for me. And you just kind of have to figure out what's going to work best for you. But I don't like the cut on the bangs necessarily. Not that I don't like it, but I don't want them this full, you know? So that was another reason, or that's another reason why I may not bring this wig to the website. Again, the hair quality is good, but that's not the only thing that I look for. I look for construction. I look for a lot of different things, you know? So I'm still in the testing phase of this wig, but I do need to definitely get something to tack this wig down, and it won't lay as flush as I want it because I still have this connected. So let me unconnect this. And also, if you're hearing that noise, if you watched the vlog earlier from this week, I believe I posted it on Monday. So I don't know when this video is going to be out, if it's going to be out on Wednesday or maybe Friday, I don't know. But if you watched that video, then you know. Huge tree limbs fell in my yard, and I, not just me, but my mom and my sons and, you know, other people helped get the tree limb or get the, you know, kind of clean up the yard as best as we could. And now we actually have one of our neighbors that came over, thank God, and said, okay, I have a chainsaw that can cut off this big tree limb up. So that's what he's doing right now. So if you hear the noise, then that's why my neighbor's out there actually doing that for me. So what I'm about to do now is I'm about to get out the house or about to go to Starbucks. I don't know if I'm going to try a new coffee or not, or just get something that I've already had, but I do want some kind of caffeine. I need to go to the bank, make a deposit. I probably won't vlog that. I also need to go to the post office, and I need to go to Walmart. So let's go. Okay, so we're on our way. So I first want to stop at Walmart and get the baggies that I need for the samples. And I'm also going to look for a planner because I've been looking for, or should I stop at the bank first? I'm trying to think which one is closest, what would make more sense. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll go to Walmart first. I'll go across the street to the bank, and then I'll go down the street to Starbucks. And then we'll go back home, package up the sample order. I decided to change the location of the camera. This is just a little bit more sturdy, so I'm sorry if it looks not as pleasing as the other angle. But the samples take a while. That's why I really need to get on making sure that I cut, like, have samples already ready to go. Because like I said, you have to cut each texture and fold them up in a way that's not gonna, and sometimes it can take a while to kind of get it to wrap the right way, especially the different textures. And not only that, but I still need to, like I said, write the textures, and this is all stuff that I can prep for. However, because I didn't prep, it just takes longer. So I've just been designating certain days to certain orders. Like, I can do traditional bundle orders today if I get done with my 4-inch weft samples, and then wholesale will probably be tomorrow. But I set myself, like, I set the proper expectations on my website with my shipping time frames, so that I don't have to feel pressured or rushed. I think a lot of people in business, they put themselves in positions where they're pressured and they're rushed to provide something that they can't provide, and they don't give themselves any wriggle room, especially if you're like a one-man business. Saying that you're going to ship hair out guaranteed the next day, in my opinion, from my experience, it's, you know, not, you know, you may want to rethink it. Not saying that you should change it or anything, but I'm just saying, when I was offering next day, and of course you can be discretionary, so you don't have to offer next day all the time, but say something happens and God forbid, you know, there's a family emergency and you can't ship out the hair right then and there. But on your website, I had that expectation. So your customers, some may understand, but some may understand and still be upset. Like, okay, I get that you have a family emergency. I get that you have this coming up. I get it. But I paid for this because I also had this happening. So what are you going to do? Are you going to reimburse me? Are you going to make it happen? Like, so I give myself the proper expectation. You know, typically I have 3 to 5 business days with shipping, and during sales, or if it's something like you know, COVID, where shipping can be delayed based on just a lot of different things, then I'll put maybe 5 to 7 business days or whatever the case may be. Whatever the case may be, you just have to figure out what's going to work best for you. But if you do it that way, then even if something happens where there's a family emergency or your car breaks down or there is an accident or whatever the case may be, or there's delayed shipments from your vendor, just different things can happen. Not saying that they will every day. Of course, these, you know, a lot of times they're one-offs, but I just like to set the right expectation. That way, no one's upset. You know, your customers have the right expectation. You're not feeling like you have to panic and get everything done. You're not feeling overwhelmed. You're not feeling like, oh my gosh, how am I going to do this? You're not snapping at your customers. You're not snapping at your vendors. You know, everything just runs smoothly. So I'd rather be, you know, my goal is not to be the cheapest. My goal is not to be the speediest. My goal is to be the most efficient and provide the most value that I can possibly provide. And when I work on those principles, so many things started to come together for me. So many things started to just be more clear and be more beneficial to not only me, but to my customers. My job, my work, you know, being an entrepreneur, it started to be more enjoyable. I didn't feel all stressed. You know, I was able to work in peace, you know, working in peace because everything was set up with the right expectations. My fundamentals, my foundation was right. I talk a lot about the foundation on my podcast. So if you're not listening to my podcast, please do so. You can do so on your way to work. You can do so on your way to the grocery store at night, sitting on the back porch, whatever you want to do, you know, but you can listen to it. And I kind of go over a lot of behind the scenes feelings of my journey as an entrepreneur. And not just that, but I include a lot of my personal, why did I put my blinker on? I guess I include a lot of my kind of personal feelings too in regards to my overall growth journey. All right, so we're at Walmart. And we're going to go in. I don't know if I'm going to vlog the whole Walmart experience, just because I don't want to have to, you know, carry my phone around. I just kind of want to get in, get out. I even have an alarm on my phone because that was my goal for today. That is my goal for today. So let's go in and then I'll let you all know what I got out of the store. Put my mask on.
Thank you.
to do like a more in-depth look at the planner and kind of go over how I feel after using the planner. Probably do the wig tomorrow, but I also have a sponsor video that I need to get out. I need to record that sponsor video today. So not only that, but like I said, I have my personal life as well with my children and with things that need to be done around the house. So are you cricket? Oop. So I have to, you know, really figure out how I'm gonna get everything done. Even if you plan really well, sometimes you just may find that things don't go as you planned, or that you plan something but there's a lot more that needs to be done. So you kind of just have to prioritize. So that's what I was doing with the wig. I'm like, is it a priority to get that washed and flat ironed today for me to continue to test? Or is it something that I can just do tomorrow? So that's what I was kind of going through the process of elimination in my mind and trying to figure out, what do I need to get done? Now, typically before the pandemic started, on a Monday, I mean, during the summer is a little bit different. So this is kind of normal for me during the summer. Well, not really, because during the summer, I still have my children in different camps. So I would probably have been already up and out earlier, and they would probably already be at camp. So the way that I move is a little bit different now, which I'm sure a lot of parents' lives are. It's a little bit different. And I was talking to someone the other day, and we were just saying how a lot of people, they're like, you know, being an entrepreneur, you're your own boss, so you don't have to do this and you don't have to do that. And that's just what I want. I want freedom. And I'm not going to lie, I mean, being an entrepreneur does provide you with a sense of freedom. But it's not like you just have free days all day. And that's what I really want to bring to the light. Like, being an entrepreneur does not mean that you have time, or that you get time to just play all day, pretty much. You just get time to kick it all day. I mean, you can choose to do that. You can choose to do that with your own job, but you may not have a job tomorrow. Same with being an entrepreneur. You can choose to do that, but you may lose a lot of customers. You may lose a lot of opportunities, you know, sponsored opportunities too. One moment. Let me call and see if anyone at home wants something from here. I'll be right back. Oh, no. It'll just be me getting Starbucks this morning, which is fine. I just want a little bit of caffeine. So like I was saying, being an entrepreneur, I think a lot of people have the wrong misconception and understanding of it, thinking that it's just a way to have freebies all day. And I mean, there'll be a point where you know when you'll get there, but it takes work.
557.
Hi. Thank you. Put some sanitizer on. I like that. That was contactless. All right. All right. Okay, so now we're gonna go back home. We're gonna get started on the orders, and then we're gonna head back out to the post office. I decided I'm not going to go to the beauty supply store right now. I'm just going to head home, get started on that, and then either I'll get the, I'll either get the stuff to wash my wig, not really wash my, I got the stuff to wash it, but to tack it on this mannequin head. I don't even know. I used to have something where I can put the mannequin head on my, I think I still have it in the office somewhere, on a table so that I don't have to hold it in between my legs while it's pinned down and flat iron it. So I have to find that too. Pretty good. I kind of forgot that I was vlogging. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and go home, and then I'll pick you all back up once I get home. Sanitize the planner and sanitize the bags, and then we'll get started cutting up the samples We'll head over to the post office and we'll see what else today brings.
Okay, so here's the update. If you do not know what I'm referring to as far as the tree falling, then please go back and watch my last vlog. I'll link it below this video. But this is the update. So most of the trees or the tree limbs that were in the yard are completely gone. I'll still have to do a little bit more raking to get the leaves and the debris up. But this is the only thing that's left, these little pieces. Just wanted to show you all before I just went in to get started. This was such a blessing. My neighbor really, really came through. God just works in amazing ways. So yeah, just, it's the only thing that's left. So today is a great day. It's a great day. All right, so I'm about to go in and sanitize the stuff we got from Walmart, and I'll be right back.
Okay, so we're back in. I wiped down everything. Here are the reusable bags that we got for the samples. I don't have my ring light plugged in because I have my phone charging. I'm gonna set on the first order. Let me show you all what it looks like. I'm gonna have to blur it out for, safety reasons and confidentiality, but I want to just show you all like what I'm looking at right now. So this is what I'm looking at. I haven't been using my computer that often, to be honest. I've really been using this. Like, this has been so convenient for me. It's just so compact, and I really, really enjoy using this tablet or this iPad. So if you have not watched my unboxing video on this iPad as well as the Magic Keyboard, then make sure you check out that video. Because yes, I have really been enjoying this. So if you're considering getting it, then I would recommend that you get it, even if you have a computer, because like I said, I find myself using this more than my computer and also more than my laptop. It's just so compact and so easy to fold up, carry around the house, prop up on my desk, in the bed, wherever I'm at, in the car. So I really enjoy using it. But this is what I'm looking at. So what I'm gonna do is write all of the textures for this order that I'm going to be cutting up for samples, and then I'll move on to the next order and so on. I'll also go ahead and package up the orders, and then I'll write the order number and also their name on the back of the envelopes, and then I'll go ahead and I'll print out the labels and then drop them off to the post office. So these are the envelopes that I'm using, the size. I do have multiple sizes, but these are the ones that I use for my samples. I also have my business cards here, because like I mentioned, I'm going to write the texture on the business cards, and then I have my hair. These are some of the bundles that I already cut up. And I do have some pieces already ready to go. Like, this looks like it's a piece that was cut, but I still have other pieces that I need to finish cutting. So yeah, here's some more. So let me go ahead and get started with the sample orders, the 4-inch weft sample orders, and I'll be right back. This is the way I do it so that I don't forget, not even forget, but I don't accidentally leave out a certain texture. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and write down the textures for this order. So I do that for each order. That way I don't forget any texture. So I write write all the textures down. That way when I get to cutting up the hair, I can just, you know, if I notice that I have an extra card left, then that's because I need another sample. You know what I mean? So it kind of just helps me work efficiently as I go. So that's the way that I've been doing it for a while. And then I counted a few times just to make sure. So for this order, they have 5 samples. So I just counted just to make sure that the 5 samples are there. Also, I write them so that they don't smear. Like, this one just smeared. So writing them and giving, like, setting them to the side gives them a chance for them to dry too. So I'm going to rewrite that one. I mean, I really don't have to, but I want to. So because I'm going to be doing multiple orders, I don't want any orders to get mixed up. So what I do is I write the order number, and I also write my customer's first and last name. That way when I print out the labels, I can match it up to the right envelope. All right. So let's go ahead and get started. So this is Mongolian Deep Wave. This is a bundle that I've already started using for samples. Again, I don't have a ring light, so, well, I do have my ring light, but it's not plugged in because I'm using my outlet to charge my phone so that I can record. So this is Mongolian Deep Wave, and I just cut about 4 inches of weft. And I've been doing it so often that I got really good at eyeing it. Another good way, if you don't know what 4 inches, like if you need a measuring tool, I'll sometimes measure it up against my phone, the side of it. And I know right about where it should end for 4 inches. So this is what it looks like. I think it's a little bit longer than 4 inches, but that's okay. This is one of our most popular textures, Mongolian Deep Wave. It's like my favorite texture. I'm probably going to put it back in maybe this weekend if I have time, or next weekend. And then I just fold it over. Okay. So that's how it looks. It's in there. The curls are not being damaged. Everything is intact. Then I go ahead and I look for the card that says Mongolian Deep Wave. And I go ahead and I put that inside of the package. Like so. And again, I've had this same routine for years. So the ink is dry now. It's not smearing. Get the air out of it. And there you go. One of the samples. So there's different ways that you can do your samples. Ultimately, I just want to make sure that it's getting there safely, and that the hair still looks good and intact when they get it. And not only that, but I'm branding it with my business card that has my website on it. It has my email address, my phone number. Your handwriting doesn't have to be the neatest. Also, what I've been putting in my samples are hair care instructions. I'm going to get some hair care instructions. I put the hair care instructions, I attached them to my bundle orders, and then I also put them inside of my sample orders. It has all the instructions on all the textures that I offer. So I'll put that in there. And then we have our first sample out of the way. And then I'll go to the next sample. Texture, which is the straight, and I cut a few pieces of straight up already, but I don't know, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut another one. This is the straight up close. So I'm really big on quality, really big on making sure that everything looks, feels good, acts good. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing, measure about 4 inches. If it's a little bit longer, that's okay. That's what it's looking like. Go ahead and I'll just kind of quickly measure it up to my phone, just eyeballing it, making sure that it looks good. I also put the textures right back up after I get done with each order. Even though I'm gonna have to do some more sample orders, I still do that just so that my hair won't get scattered around, and you know, I don't want anything to fall or anything to, you know, get mixed up or get into the you know, wrong bag or anything like that. So it just kind of helps to keep things organized. So then I do the same thing. Let me go ahead and take out, I plastic bag. I do the same thing. And then I go ahead and I find the business card that says straight. Put that in there. Squeeze the air out. Okay, so now I have two samples. Okay, then we'll move on to the next textures. Body wave, I put the deep wave, and then I put the kinky curly at the top. Make sure everything looks pretty good, and then I go ahead, tear that off, and seal up the first sample order. Now I'm gonna remember whose sample order this is, because remember I wrote down the order number and also the name. So that's that. And then I come over here, and then it starts creating the label, and then also it shows fulfill now. Feels fulfilled. I'm gonna do the same process again with the next order, and I will pick you all back up on my way to the post office. Hey everyone, okay, so it's been a long day. I'm actually at the post office now. I went to Meijer's to get some groceries for the boys, for like lunch and snacks, and we also needed some more tissue, toilet paper. So I'm at the post office now. I'm about to go in, drop off the orders, and also pick up some supplies for my drop shipping clients, and then I'll be right back when I get home. It's really hot, so I'm just gonna hurry up, go in here, and pick up the camera and let you all know. Probably close out the vlog when I get home. So just a quick update.